The one thing we know for certain about Bach's musical education, and this specifically as an organist, is that he went to considerable trouble to go and hear the greatest organists around. And as far as we can tell, he always went on foot, often for very considerable distances. He walked 50 miles to hear Dietrich Buxtehude, not only an eminent composer, but one of the greatest organists of all time. When he was 17, he reached the end of his formal schooling and was now on his own, fending for himself wherever he chose to. Information here is very sparse, but we do know that in 1702, despite his youth and lack of experience, he was offered the job of church organist in the town of Sangerhausen. The next year found him employed very briefly as a lackey. This was the formal job description at the court of Weimar, where he seems also to have been active as both organist and violinist. In 1703, Bach was appointed organist at the Neue Kirche in the German town of Arnstadt. He was just the latest in a long line of Bachs who had looked after the music in Arnstadt since around 1620. He was now 18 years of age and was already well known, not only as an organist, but as an expert assessor of organs. Though he never, as far as we know, had any training as an organ builder, he brought to the testing of organs a builder's expertise. Apart from his innate sensitivity to the acoustical properties of instruments and the buildings which housed them, he made the most meticulous judgments of wind pressure and voicing, even of the thickness and quality of the metal used for the organ's pipes. It was also at around this time, at the very outset of his career, that he wrote what's probably his best-known work, and certainly the most famous organ piece ever composed, the dramatic and extensive Toccata and Fugue in D minor, which we'll hear now in its entirety.